Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Chapter some basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry, and we are doing the topic determination of percentage of nitrogen by Duma's method in an organic compound. In the last lecture, we have studied about the Duma's method for the estimation of the percentage of the nitrogen in an organic compound, and based on this only we are going to do a numerical or a problem which will be related that how can we calculate the percentage of nitrogen if few data are been given to us. So let us do it. So this is what we are going to do, that is a determination of percentage of nitrogen, and this is a numerical, and for which let us understand that what has been given to us. So they are saying that in Duma's method for estimation of nitrogen, 0.30 gram of an organic compound gives 50 ml of the nitrogen collected at 300 Kelvin temperature and 715 mmHg pressure. So we have to calculate the percentage of nitrogen. So therefore this is basically the Duma's method that is in representing, and in that also what we are going to what we did was basically we have combust the organic compound in the form of carbon dioxide, hydrogen and the nitrogen gas, and now that nitrogen gas is been collected in the nitrometer, and that gas that is the nitrogen gas has a volume of basically which has been collected in the nitrometer is basically 50 ml, and the temperature on which the process was been done, or basically the nitrogen was collected, it was at 300 Kelvin, and the pressure, the atmospheric pressure that we could say that the outer pressure was basically 715 mmHg, and for that the compound was given as 0.30. So now let us do the first thing, that is let us write the data that are been given in the given question, so therefore it would be very much easy for us to write or to represent that how the answer has came. So let us do that. So talking about the first one, that is the given data is basically the m, or we could say that the mass of the organic compound. So therefore we could write it in this way, that is mass of organic compound. That is m is given as 0.30 gram. And the volume where in the nitrometer that it was been collected, that is of the nitrogen, it was been found to be 50 ml. So therefore, the volume that is been collected in the nitrogen, not at STB, but at the condition which has been provided, it has been given as V1. So therefore, the volume of nitrogen, I would write it over here as volume of nitrogen collected. That is V1, it has been given as 50 ml. And talking about the next one, that is it has been given as that the temperature at which it was been collected, it was, we could write it as T1, and the T1 is basically, so therefore the T1 that has been given is 300 Kelvin. And talking about the next one, that is the external pressure that has been maintained, or we could see that 715 mm pressure is being maintained, so therefore we could write the pressure as P is equals to, that is 715 mm. And talking about the next data that has also been provided to us, and that is aqueous tension at 300 Kelvin. So at 300 Kelvin, the aqueous tension is basically 15 mm. So therefore, we could write the aqueous tension in the form of F is equals to, that is 15 mm. So this P is the external pressure and is not the actual pressure of the nitrogen that has been maintained. So we have to calculate the pressure of the nitrogen also. So therefore, what we could do is, we have the formula for that. So the term P1 is given for the pressure of the nitrogen, and it can be calculated as P1 is equals to, that is P minus F. So the value of P, that is the pressure that is being given as, that is 715, and that is of the aqueous tension that is being given as 15. So if we calculate this thing, then the value is basically 700. So therefore 700 mmHg of the pressure is being maintained by the nitrogen. So therefore this is what we have got, but this is the value of P1 that we have got. And yes, we have also the volume values of like volume and T1. So if we have this much of values with us and of a different condition, so we could equate it with the ideal gas equation that we know, that is according to ideal gas equation, that is P1 V1 upon T1 is equals to P2 V2 upon T2. So this P2V2/T2 is nothing but the pressure, volume and temperature at STP. So therefore this is the condition at STP that we have to maintain. So as to calculate that, what would the value of the volume of the nitrogen that has been collected in terms of STP. So we know that at STP the pressure is basically 760 mmHg and that of the temperature is basically 273 Kelvin, and from that we could easily calculate the volume of the nitrogen at this condition. So therefore let us substitute the values over whatever we have got for the pressure and volume and temperature. So let us do that. So therefore in this case the P1 which was been calculated, it was basically 700, and that of the volume, that is V1, it was been found to be basically 50 in the experiment, and that of the temperature that was been maintained during the collection of this one, it was basically 300. But at STP the value of P2, that what we have given the term as, so the value of P2 is basically 760, and we don't know the volume of the nitrogen in this case at STP. So therefore V2 is the thing that we have to calculate, and talking about that is T2 is basically 273 Kelvin. So now it would be very much easy for us to calculate what will the volume of, that is I would write over here as volume of nitrogen at STP. So this is what we have to calculate, and that would be nothing but we will do the cross multiplication. So therefore 700 into, that is 50 into 273, the whole divided by 760 into 300. So let's calculate this thing, and yes, the value that we could get will be having a unit of milliliter. So therefore let us calculate this thing and do the further part. So we have got a value of, that is 4190 milliliter. So therefore if we convert the volume that we have got, it was basically 50 ml but at a particular temperature and pressure. So suppose if we convert it into STP condition, that we have got to be, that is 41.90 ml. So now this is the volume that we have got, and now we would be very much, it would be easy for us to calculate that what would be the gram or what would be the percentage of the nitrogen that we have obtained. So now regarding this what we have got, so it would be very much easy for us. And for what we know that at STP, that is if we have 22,400 milliliter of nitrogen, so that would occupy, or that would consist of basically 28 gram of nitrogen. But the volume that we have the volume that we have got, it was basically 4190 ml. So therefore we could say that 4190 ml of nitrogen will be equal to, suppose like x, suppose if I have written over here as x, so therefore we could calculate by cross multiplication where we could multiply 28 multiply by 41.90, so therefore 28 multiply by 41.90, the whole divided by basically 22400, and that would be in present in gram. So therefore if we calculate this thing, then let us see what is the answer that we could get. So we have got a value of, that is 0.0523 gram of nitrogen. So this is what we have got, means that is 41.90 ml of nitrogen consists of 0.0523 gram of nitrogen. So this is what we have got, and for which we could easily calculate what would be the percentage. So therefore it is very much easy to calculate, that is the percentage of nitrogen, that is what we have to calculate. So in this case basically the organic compound that we have calculated and or that they have provided to us, it was basically 0.30 gram, and that of in which the percentage of nitrogen it was been found to be for what we could say that the gram, the mass of the nitrogen, it was found to be 0.0523. so therefore if we divide this thing in this way, that is 0.0523 divided by the amount of the organic compound, and that is basically 0.30, and if we, because we have to do the percentage calculation, so therefore we will multiply by 100. So let us see what is the answer that we could get. So in this case we have got the value of, that is 17.45% of nitrogen. So this is what we have found out, and the percentage of nitrogen. It was very much easy. That is, what we have did is, we have the total amount of the organic compound, and in which we have got after doing the calculation, and this was based on the Duma's method, and in which we have got that is 0.0523 gram of the nitrogen was been present. So we have did a calculation and we have multiplied by 100, and this is what we have got. So this is the percentage of nitrogen that we have got, and in that organic compound. So in any organic compound, we could find out by using the Duma's method. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood the Duma's method. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.